Keeping it real, Mietzki. Mietzki was probably the best part of this episode and the somewhat finale. I think we still got one more episode to completely clear everything up with Sumire and, you know, the Anbu or whatever. But Mietzki was the best part of this episode because of seeing his character, getting more of an understanding of who he is, what he's about, and also seeing the first somewhat betrayal he's done to... you know who, come on, man. Why are they playing these games? We've seen the movie, you know what I mean? We read the manga. But the first betrayal to Orochimaru, his parents or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Because he didn't do everything that he said he would do. You know what I mean? Killing, I guess he was supposed to kill Sumire to get, you know, at all costs or whatever, just end her and shit like that. He didn't do it. But just seeing his character throughout the episode, seeing his viciousness, not giving a fuck, I'm going to kill this bitch if I have to, seeing his relationship with Boruto, seeing him fucking going in. This kid, they're not even Genin yet. But he was fucking putting in the works with his moves against Nue. And I gotta give it, that was the all-star of this episode, hands fucking down. I mean, Shikadai and them really weren't there. It's like, as of right now, as a matter of fact, I'm gonna put it like this. Aside from Shikadai, which is my own personal bias, Mietzki is one of the best characters of the Boruto series. Boruto is whatever, like him or hate him and shit like that. Shikadai, I like him for my own reasons of, hey, he's pretty much Shikamaru just reborn, you know what I mean? So that's why I like Shikadai. So it's, again, a little bit of a bias because I'm a huge Shikamaru fan. But Mietzki, he brings a different dynamic to this one where it's kind of a little more complex. He's a little more of a, I don't want to say deep, because he's not like the most, you know, deepest thing ever, but he's a little bit more deep than the other characters in the Boruto cast, so I fucked with Mietzki very heavy after this episode. He put in work. With that being said, the Nue beast, what the fuck? Very disappointing on his power, because when he was in the village, it looked like Naruto was gonna have to jump in, and you see everybody trying to restrain him and all that shit, and I guess you could argue that that was attributed to all the stolen chakra, and essentially he's kind of like a kitten right now, or a puppy or something, you know, he wasn't completed or whatever. But I was like, bro, when we saw the last week's episode, and we saw this giant monster, and he was fucking shit up, it was like, hey, this is the Nine Tails all over again. Hell's fucking yeah. And then you see in this episode, Boruto's outwitting him. Mietzki is straight bodying the fuck out of him. I'm like, what? This was supposed to be the beast that came through and really was gonna wreck shit. And Boruto, you gotta think again. Mind you, okay, Mietzki, he's probably strong enough to maybe even be a Chunin, you know what I'm saying? And he, with enough guidance, he could probably even be a Jonin, because he looks like he's there. Boruto, he's an exceptionally gifted kid. But still, they are officially not even Genin. And I know people say, well, Naruto was only a Genin and he was taking on Madara. But it's a different case. These are little fucking kids that haven't really been around the block yet. At the very least, Boruto hasn't. Why the fuck was Nue getting bodied throughout the episode? He really didn't do much. I mean, the most that was happened wasn't even from Nue. It was Sumire stabbing Boruto in the arm accidentally when she was charging against Mietzki. I was like, what? And something that I talked about, if you watched my previous Boruto video regarding the preview for this one or the spoilers for this one, whatever you want to call it. It seems as though Talk No Jutsu is alive. It's alive and well, and it resides within Boruto Uzumaki, aka Naruto 2.0, because he pulled one. He pulled one where he was like, no. I mean, the little fucking bitch, and I'm gonna call her that because at the end of the day, she was willing to kill everyone. She didn't give a shit. She fucking played everyone. She lied. She pretended to be a Hinata, which that fucked me a bit. Like, bro, don't pretend to be my Hinata Swan, and then you're a piece of shit. She played everyone, and then Boruto's like, oh no, but you know, I know the truth. Motherfucker, she lied! She played you! She was a true shinobi in that sense, you know what I mean? What the fuck you mean that? Like, I was just kind of like, really? Ah, talk no jutsu. So a little bit, two things about the episode. Nue, what the fuck? Really? Like, call him a kitten, call him a puppy, but still, he really wasn't impressive, especially after showing the feats that he did. And Konoha, maybe it was the chakra was drained by the time he got to Boruto and Mietzki. Let's throw that there, why not? But still, wasn't really impressive in the fight against Mietzki and Boruto. And then Boruto ultimately talking Sumire down with the talk no juice. So I was just kind of like... When he was saying the speech, I liked the impact, if anything. If that speech had any positive impact narrative-wise in any other way, it was seeing the effect it had on Mietzki. Because Mietzki, his whole thing has been kind of observing Boruto. Well, what will he do in this situation? How will he react to this situation? that was kind of cool. And that was interesting to see Mitsuki's reaction and kind of him looking at Boruto and saying, oh shit, you know, you really are interesting. And, you know, there's going to be some development out of all of that for Mitsuki because he sees that Boruto is genuinely a good kid. So that was the best thing out of the talking of Jutsu, because other than that, Sumire being talked down after this being her life mission because of her parents and Nue getting busted around, I'm like, are you kidding me? It was cool. It was cool seeing them in the other dimension and shit like that. And also the little explanation I liked as well from Kakashi, which it might have been mentioned in original Naruto. I don't remember. It kind of sounds familiar to me. That the beast that gets summoned, like, you know, Gamabunta and fucking the Kyuubi and all of them, they do reside somewhere in this world when you summon these beasts. And I don't know why did I say Kurama or the Kyuubi, you know. Just in general, the beast, the frog, you know, the slug, the Orochimaru snake, all of them, like, they reside somewhere in this world, which showcases, okay, the Naruto verse is actually bigger than we think. Again, that might have been mentioned in OG Naruto. If it was, I forgot. It's been a while, you know what I'm saying? But I like that little piece of information in there. It was also cool in the beginning of the episode to see Naruto kind of using, you know, a mode that hasn't been used in a while. I was kind of like, okay, you know, he's checking shit out to see nature or whatever the hell. I can't even remember the name of the move. Oh my god, and I've been doing this for 7 years. Fucking kill me, you know what I mean? But anyway, it was cool to see that as well. As a whole, honestly, to get to the fucking meat and bones and the fucking tooth of it all, not the best way. It felt like one of those kind of, I don't fucking know, remind me of, for whatever reason, it reminded me of like Pokemon the movie 3 with the Entei movie. I don't know, it just kind of felt like, okay, Boruto talked her out of it, and, you know, I'm imagining at some given point maybe we might see Sumire again down the road or something, but her leaving off with Sai, because Sai understands her, which was a good thing to introduce Sai into this, you know, arc or whatever, this little, well, I was gonna say mini arc, but essentially this arc span from the beginning of Boruto till now, it made sense. So it's like, okay, maybe she can reform, who knows, maybe she'll fucking commit seppuku while she's with Sai or some shit right there, you know what I'm saying, but who knows. I mean, personally, if we're gonna have any value in these filler characters like Sumire, then they do need a return at some given point and have a vital role. Especially, she was like, these are not even genin. I gotta keep stressing that. They're not fucking even genin. They're not even, you know, Naruto, Sasuke, and Sakura when they first joined up with Kakashi. They're not even certified yet. And Sumire looks like that bitch could be even a chunin or some shit like that. So she's kind of OP. Mitsuki OP, Boruto's just really, really smart, but the rest of the kids, aside from maybe Sarada, because she's an Uchiha, they're fucking scrubs in comparison, you know what I mean? And Boruto is even somewhat, in my opinion, scrubs compared to Mitsuki and fucking Sumire. Like, I could see Mitsuki busting down Hanabi, you know, when Boruto fought Hanabi. I could see Mitsuki kind of taking her out the way he was displaying fucking epicness in this episode. So, episode a bit disappointing with the finale, a bit disappointing with the big monster in the end, because he really wasn't shit. And then, I mean, it was, I don't want to say heartfelt, but I get where they were going with it, and it was somewhat emotional to see Nue kind of taking to Sumire, so in that regard, okay, fine. Art was a little here or there. There was some cool pieces, especially towards the end when we saw Boruto with, you know, joining up with Shikadai and whatever, and the fact that he didn't want to keep talking about it with them, he's like, I don't want to talk about it. Just fucking tell them, you know what I'm saying? Then I guess seeing Boruto using his eye, hopefully this eye doesn't get completely hopefully it doesn't get erased, but remember, that's shown in the beginning of the story, so we'll just have to wait and see. Again, as a whole, I wasn't really digging the way it was handled too much. It kind of felt like taking some shit that we've seen in Naruto before, the talk no jutsu, the fact that, you know, the enemy really wasn't that strong, like it was chalked up to be, and I was like, it felt mediocre. It felt, for a finale, it was like, last week's episode was dope, because Nue looked impressive. This one, like, again, I gotta stress, the best thing about the episode was fucking Mitsuki. Dude is awesome. I want to see more Mitsuki. Have him more often in Boruto, and we're good to go, because right now, him, Shikadai, throw in Sarada, and of course Boruto, and we got a good mix right there. Really curious what you guys think about it, though. First of all, are you disappointed with the Nue beast? Do you think that he didn't live up to the hype, or he was fine, or you got the kitten excuse for him? Also, what do you think about Sumire being talked down from her life's vengeance for her parents, you know, trying to avenge her parents by talk no jutsu? Do you think that this is going to be applied more often? I really, really hope that this talk no jutsu shit doesn't continue on and on and on, because it seems as though Boruto is essentially, even though he's supposed to be finding his own ninja way, he's doing the same shit that his father did. And it's like, you're supposed to find your way. And don't get me wrong, talk no jutsu, very good lesson for kids, you know. You don't always gotta fight to the death. You can talk it out. Sometimes you can't talk shit out. There are some people in this world that you cannot talk down, no matter how nice you are, how you approach them. And I think that also needs to be a lesson that's implemented. It wasn't really implemented towards the end the Naruto, let's implement it in Boruto. Everyone can't be talked down from the fucking ledge. Some people are gonna jump. And I know I got a little angry there, whatever. It's not like I hated the episode, but it was mediocre, just being honest. And your overall thoughts of the episode, how do you feel? I'm looking forward to the next arc. I'd imagine we're gonna have a couple of, you know, okay episodes, and then hopefully we get to Sada that guy then. So we'll see where it goes. But that's all I have for this one. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you liked anything I had to say or enjoyed the video, draw me a like. I'd greatly appreciate it. And if you want more from me, make sure to subscribe, follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and stalk my Facebook to get more. When the video ends, I'm Fanebo World, and as always, people, bang! Have an awesome day.